So it's Uncle Bo coming to you from on location. And anyway, we're going into Walmart, and we'll see if we could son of a bitch record him in there and shit like that. So we'll see you later. So we're son of a bitch recording Walmart. I don't know if you can see if anything. Okay. Something like that. Video's probably gonna suck because I can't see what I'm doing. The color up top. Okay. Okay. We're in Walmart on see you can't. Oh look. It's Paula Deen. See if they have a candy thermometer just for shits. I forget if it was this Azel or the other one. There's not one of them because I was down here just before. I think it was back the other way. And we're going this way now. Oh, you can. Yes, they do. They've got big balls. Check that out. That is like the fucking one right here. No, that's like the one on Sesame Street. Check this out. Don't you remember that? With the blue stripes and the even the pink one here with the stars on it. And the spotted one down here. Did you see this one down here? That's awesome. So now we're just wandering around. Ooh, 70 inch. No name brand goodness. So now we're going into Big Y, but we gotta hit the bridge first down over there because I think they have quicker in there. Yeah, I like that kind. So anyway, we're gonna go in there first, and then son of a bitch in the Big Y. Okay, we're back home now. We went to the stores, and now we were there for way too long, and spent too much kind of money. But I have some stuff here, tonic water kind with lime, and I have the Zephyr Gin. However, the wife had the shakes, so we had to start with this here, and we had to get Chizo while we were at the store, and it's as close to Florida as you've since then. Oh, something got knackered, but anyway, she's on the port salute and the wine hard. You want to salute the port?
Salute the port.
Salute the port. So now I have that, and I have the Zephyr Gin kind over here in the tonic water. So now all I gotta do is, I don't know, it's kind of hard, but I can put those in there. And once we do that, then I have a drink kind. So did you have a good glass of wine?
I did.
Damn sure did. I got a potato roll and some sauerkraut over there. And over here, see, and now we got music that she likes on. So we roasted garlic. We'll see how bad we did.
Oh, smells awesome.
It does smell great. Oh, look at the golden brown. The golden brown. I love it. It looks beautiful. So we'll see what happens. We got lots more cooking coming up here. We'll see you later. See, now she's opening the wino. Squeeze it as you turn it. Squeeze it together, like on the crevice type, as you turn it. There you go. Okay. Now, let me just, let's see here. I need to hold on a second because I only got one hand. Just a minute with the camera there. Okay, now, sorry about that.
open, put it down, squeeze together. Squeeze together tight all the way down. Keep squeezing together all the way up.
Squeeze hard. That's a good girl.
There you go.
Yay!
And now squeeze it together and go down and back up. Squeeze it together and go back up.
And then the cork pops out.
There you go. And that was kept outside in the snow. I'll take that in a minute because I only got one hand here.
Let's go.
Oh, let's go. She's ready for the wine.
This part, see? That's the foil.
So anyway, she's on the wine hard. Look, oh shit, look at this. All right, so we just deglazed the pan. We had some shallots and garlic in there. Separate from that, I'll get to it in a second. But anyway, 66. So anyway, that's going. We're deglazing the pan now. And over here, we roasted some garlic. See, it's roasted, which we took out before. We just had a, now some prosciutto going in, just because you can. So anyway, we deglazed it and put the garlicated and made it roasted. And you see it's all browned. So we're gonna figure out what happens next. We got some tortellini and all kinds of good shit to go in there. Some clamo juice going in. See, whole bottle kind. Make a soup. And we'll see what else happens later. So here's the shred. That's three bulbs of roasted garlic and a shtick of butter and some parsley kind.
Okay.
And that looks good. And then it disappeared. Anyway,
it
goes over here. And now we got bread and everything else, and then that's going to go in the oven and all kinds of stuff. And we got the pasta over there in the pan. All the stuff in there. Now out into the dungeon with the creaky door. See, we have a special thing here. We have the wino in the snow. This is, we have that kind. So we'll take that out. It's I just need another hand for a second. Unless we're drinking. Same shit I drink on my birthday, but like a whole bottle kind. And it's ice fucking cold with the crystals on the side that are melting right now. Dinner's done. That's what we got. And this is only the first day. All right, so it's after dinner now. We're all securely knackered. And I'd like to tell you a very short story. If you had watched the Detergent Day videos, you would see about the Tempo detergent. I forget it was part 9, part 10, part 11, part 8. I forget exactly what it was. But whenever I got that, I noticed that the bottles were a bit knackered. And I said that that would not affect the detergentism of them. Well, as it turns out, it certainly did, because the bottles leaked. They leaked on the floor, on the carpet, which was the video before the fire, after the fire. And what had happened was, I contacted the company and I said, look, your shit leaked on my floor, what the fuck? And they said, okay, listen, we're not really responsible for what happens once it leaves our factory, but we don't want to just leave you like that, so what can we do for you? I said, all right, look, I cleaned the rug already because I found it in the garage, we moved in, it was garbage, whatever. So I said, I'll tell you what, why don't you replace the product and send me $25 for my trouble. Just something, you know, not a whole big deal. So she says, okay, that actually sounds excellent. So what I'm going to do is send you a check for $25, and I'm also going to send you a replacement detergent. So she did. She sent me Tempo regular detergent and Tempo with bleach alternative. So she sent me that, and that's all fine good to replace the stuff. But she also stuffed in the box 2 bottles of dishwashing liquid. Well, it turns out, months and months and months later, almost even a year later, we happen to run out of dishwashing liquid at home. I'm not talking about stuff in the dishwasher. I'm just talking about when you wash it in the sink before you throw it in the dishwasher, because you don't need to. So anyway, that stuff, that's what I'm talking about. She sent me 2 bottles of almond cream flavor, and as strange as that sounds, when I learned we were running just about out of that stuff, instead of running to the store, I remembered that we actually had some of that, and I said, well, as shit as this probably is, let's use it. Well, it turns out that that stuff was the best, absolutely the fucking best manual dishwashing liquid that we've ever seen. There was a greasy pan and just a drip of soap in that left shit squeaky fucking clean. And we did some research and found that it's distributed in the New York area and up on the New England area here by Tops Distributors, something like that. But anyway, we ended up with Valentine brand. See over here, which we found at Big Y. Now, Big Y has their own Big Y brand dishwashing stuff. This stuff, I swear, for this bottle was $1. And it's doing an absolute crackpot job. It's just fucking amazing. It's taken away every little bit of grease here. And wait until we do this pan. That's gonna be the next video. Because it's got shit all over it. And you're gonna see how this soap actually works. God forbid you actually have to scrub something, which is gonna take a little bit of rubbing just to get this out. And this is cast iron. This weighs a ton. Okay, she did this top of it just before, which I don't know where it went for now, but anyway, it was done, I saw it before, but regardless, this is cast iron, porcelain coated. So we'll see how it does on that. We'll come back in a bit. All right, we're ready. Just a minute. So we got the soap. Okay, so here's the pan. We just had a little bit of other dishwashing stuff. Just no soap whatsoever, just water. Now here's the soap on the sponge. And just whatever goop was in the pan. And here's just a spoon. Apparently the birds are on cigarettes again, but that's all right. So there's the spoon. Now here's the pan. Now that was all sort of deglazed in there. And you see how it's not moving? Now let's put some soap on it. Take a little look at that. Who would have fucking known that dishwashing was this goddamn exciting with your dollar Valentine bullshit, which is actually the Tempo soap. It's the same thing. Let me actually just show you. If you do find this, you want to look for it being distributed by Topco Associates. Your first 6 of the UPC, which means the actual brand, is 811225. That would indicate that this would be the soap, because we can't quite find it in this area, especially up here in Connecticut. But anyway, you see the pan is absolutely clean. This is porcelain coated cast iron, and it is absolutely squeaky fucking clean.
There's nothing to it, just like that. Amazing.
All right, so it's after dinner, and the animals are getting fooded now. So we got that stuff. We're fooding the animals then. This one's busy with her bone kind, because that's what dogs do. And we got the shoutcast kind going on. Spring morning here. You'll see what else that animal kind of thing. So anyway, and in the background here, I'm editing together some YouTube videos just to try to find out what's happening. And those will be up before you actually see this video, so I beg my pardon. We're coming up over here, so we'll see what else the night brings. On the game hard? No? Are you on the Nosentine's Day hard? Do you like the Nosentine's Day?
I do.
But we're expensive, we go to Walmart for that kind.
He's very pretty.
Oh, look at that. What'd you find in there?
Necklace.
Is that right?
He's very pretty. Thank you.
Alright, well, they finished the chambord, so that indicates that they made a pretty awesome drink that, of course, I ended up making for them. That's some of that milk kind in there. And this, of course, is the tonic water. Not too much left. Because that goes to my glass. That's the glass I have for now. And I don't know how well you can see this. We'll bring it over here. This was a brand new bottle. Maybe one more drink will be about half fullish. And that's about right for an evening. So this $25 bottle lasts me about two evenings. Good deal. Just parking there for some breakfast. Maybe some orange juice or something like that. If not, I have some vodka. And I also have cornberry juice down in there. By the way, Mike Rowe on Jerdy Dobbs. This kind. He gets into all kinds of shit. But what happened was my pantaloons, they had a problem because I had to open up the water heater to change the temperature on it. It was a little too cold for this time of year. And when I did that, a lot of rusty water came out when I removed the insulation. And it splashed on my pantaloons, and that wasn't cool. So I used that shit on it and just let it kind of air dry while I still wore it, kind. It's gone now, so I guess it'll completely beg its pardon when I wash it. Anyway, that's all for now, so beg your pardon.